Brothers and sisters in Islam, I ask you a question. Who among us here guarantees right now and is confident enough to stand up and say by Allah's name that they have never done a sin in their life? By Allah's name, you have never made a mistake in your life. By Allah's name, you have never sinned while knowing in your life. None of us can. If you do say you are lying, you are lying to yourself, you are lying to the people, and you are lying to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah knows it. For it is out of the nature in which Allah has created us, in that He created us in the nature that we will make mistakes, we err, we move away. But for a believer, it is through these mistakes that we learn to come back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And when you return back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, how do you feel? How do you feel? Isn't your iman doubled, tripled, when you regret and you cry and you admit your sin? You feel even closer to Allah than before. This is why seeking forgiveness from Allah for us and for the dead are among the best virtues and the best good acts that anyone can do. Rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam used to say, for example, "Tuba liman wajada fi sahifatihi istighfaran kathira." Good news to the one who on the day of judgment will open their record and they will find in their records many instances in their lives that they have sought forgiveness from their Lord. Astaghfirullah, from their heart. And now you are seeking forgiveness for your dead brother or sister in Islam. Yes, your dua, seeking forgiveness for the person who has died, reaches the person Allah will forgive them on your behalf. Now Allah knows how much this person is to be forgiven. Allah knows that you will seek forgiveness for them. But this benefit is for us. This benefit is for the living. And at the same time, Allah, out of His mercy and compassion, has made it also that the brothers and the sisters are for each other. Even after their death, yes, even after their death. A person may ask, when their father has died, or their mother has died, or if brother or a sister or their child has died, or a relative, what is it that you yearn for? You say to yourself, if I can have only 5 more minutes, just 5 more minutes to see my father or mother again, 5 more minutes to see my child again, just to say how much I love them. Isn't that right? It's the nature of the human. 5 more minutes, 2 more minutes, just to come back. I just want to look at them one more time. Say one word to them. My brothers and sisters in Islam, that will never happen. Allah says, وَلَنْ يُؤَخِّرَ اللَّهُ نَفْسًا إِذَا جَاءَ أَجَلُهَا. Allah will never delay a single soul when its time has come. However, look what He gives us. You have the opportunity to supplicate for them and it will reach them. It will reach them like a gift. And in fact, in one of the hadiths narrated in Sunan Ahmad, it says that when a person has died, they suddenly find gifts of rewards coming to them and their levels are being raised. And they say, where is this from, my Lord? For my deeds have ended me here. Where am I getting more deeds from? Why is my level rising? And it will be said to him or her, you have a righteous child that is still supplicating for you. You have a righteous child that is still supplicating for you. Or you have a righteous child who is donating on your behalf. Or someone is. You know the hadith that we mentioned last week, that the rewards that keep going for the dead person, ongoing charity, ongoing knowledge, or righteous child that is supplicating for you. This is out of the mercy and compassion of Allah. It is not the end. You can keep going, alhamdulillah. I was at a funeral the other day, and the parents or the children asked me, what can I do for my father? And this is what we said you can do. Supplicate for them. Ask for dua for them. Forgiveness, mercy. Oh Allah, make their grave a garden from the gardens of paradise. Oh Allah, give them mercy from your mercy. Oh Allah, be generous to them. Oh Allah, be compassionate towards them. Oh Allah, my father has taught me this. I ask you to reward him for what he has taught me. There are many good words you can say, and Allah will respond to them bi-idhnihi ta'ala. Allah loves this when people supplicate for them. And there are also angels, as we said last week, who say ameen to the supplication of a Muslim for another Muslim. When you supplicate for another Muslim, in the Sahih Hadith it says that there is an angel standing there saying, وَلَكَ مِثْلُهُ وَلَكَ مِثْلُهُ وَلَكَ مِثْلُ ذَلِكَ وَلَكَ مِثْلُ ذَلِكَ. And for you, we ask God for the same thing. And for you, we ask Allah for the same thing that you are asking for your brother or sister. So supplicate for the dead and ask Allah for forgiveness for them, my dear brothers and sisters, for it is through the forgiveness that people rise and enter paradise.